From the Holiday Magazine, War Memorials, July 1946. Its story is typical. Late in 1943, the Chamber of Commerce appointed a memorial committee, which recommended erection of a plaque or monument. A request went out for donations, and there was little interest and less response. Something's wrong, W.L. Lipka and Walter Hunt, co-chairman of the project, told each other. So they talked with their neighbors. They wrote to the American Commission for Living War Memorials in Columbus, Ohio, for advice. What the people wanted, they decided, was a memorial that would not only commemorate the war service of their sons and daughters, but would also have lasting value to the community. Armed with this new idea, Lipka and Hunt successfully petitioned the town council and the Board of Education for $500 each to buy some available used equipment to light the high school football field. With surprising ease, a finance committee obtained further donations of $7,150 from individuals, from the Girl Scouts, the senior class at the high school, the city firemen, other groups, and a community dance added $150 to the fund. 27 lots adjoining the school site were purchased. Then the farmers held their grading bee, helped by businessmen and workmen who donated their time to toil with picks and shovels, and by the volunteer survivors. The memorial was born.
I'm Harold Kasner.
I'm Jack Lipka. We're here. We started doing this, resurrecting the story of the memorial field through the museum. And we wanted to bring it back so people understood what happened here in 1945 as far as the community was concerned in making this living memorial in honor of these veterans that are here on this plaque.
It was all brought about by the goodwill of the citizens of Montague. It didn't take long. They just said they needed, and they got so much money to get started. And they got started, and then Wendell says, we got to get so many more dollars to pay the people that are working on the field. And within no time at all, it was paid for.
Well, my dad was a financial chairman, and Walt Hunt was in charge of the grounds, getting the work done and stuff. And they both got the people behind them and raised the money and got the work done. There was people out here working on everything. The farmers brought in manure spreaders full of manure when it was graded. And they worked it in the ground and did things. Everybody pitched in. The farmers did with their tractors and stuff. The main grade was done by Dobb Truck and Crane out of Muskegon. But then everybody locally took over and did the all seating and the things. And the light bulbs were put in.
How long did it take them to clear the land?
Not too long, I don't think.
Because
they started in the spring and they played football here that fall. It was pretty sandy. But
Now what's been done to it since then?
Well, since then it was used up to a football field until 2004 or 5. And then they turned it into the soccer field when they built a new stadium at the high school. So it's still used for soccer all the time.
They always had to stand up on both sides, Glenn Lipka and Dick Hill. We called him Ike. They got out and raised the fund to put these bleachers up. And then, you know, you can't have bleachers just for your crowd, so they put bleachers for the... They're gone.
They're gone, yeah.
They put bleachers for the...
Opposing
team, so, but only half as many.
So those are gone now.
I don't know.
Probably over at the baseball diamond or girls softball or something.
Does the scoreboard still work?
I don't know. Yeah, I imagine they use it but, now for soccer.
You know.
Do they use the press box for anything anymore, or is that just
for their soccer game.
They,
yeah.
They do have the announcer and stuff in the press box.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
good. So the PA is all still working.
Yeah.
When all the original light poles were here.
Yeah.
One of the Ben Quinn had a post up there so he could see the whole field, and he used to give the what's going on the field. And then they put the press box up and got rid of the other lights.
They bought, I think, 19 lots from the lady here that owned all this. And it was this woods, old grubs and stuff, and they put it in and put that terrace in and got the... And they built a skating rink up where the parking lot now. It used to be the bus garage was on top of the skating rink at the time. And Carter Oil Company was working out in Clay Banks, drilling wells at that time, and they supplied all the clay liner for the skate rink. So it was a whole total community. Everybody got behind it, and it worked. There's one article in the paper tells about the seating where they walked lengthwise and crossways with the old hand crank seaters. And afterwards, they went to Bill Gillen's house for refreshments.
But they said that right at near the end, we need $800 more, and no time at all that they had it.
It was a time when people were just coming off of the stamps for food, tires, gasoline was rationed. I mean, the local people didn't have much at that time, in the 30s and early 40s. But when the war was getting over and everybody was going, boys were coming home, those that made it, they were willing to put their shoulder to the wheel and get this done.
A lot of people don't know that they see the Montague VFW come down to the parade field in Whitehall at the causeway, but VFW actually comes up here first and honors this plaque, and then mounts downtown and walks over to it.
The VFW used to come before football games and raise the flag. Montague was recognized in the Holiday magazine, which was a like look and post in them at that time. It's not in business anymore. As a city that built a living memorial for the men and women in the service.
A three-page spread.
Now it's used for all the soccer games and stuff. And other, the school uses a lot for different classes come down and do things or have picnics and stuff.
Thank you. take my lips. I want to lose them. Take my arms, I'll never use them. Your goodbye left me with eyes that cry. How can I go on, dear, without you? You took the part that once was my heart, so why not take all of me?